described in Captioned Media Program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Great Cup Stack Challenge, written by Kathleen Vaughn, Maryland School for the Blind. Captioning services provided by Caption Perfect. Caption editors Will Hallman and Aaron Gibbs.
A title, Social Skills Cinema, the Maryland School for the Blind. A narrator reads on-screen text.
Each week, students from the Maryland School for the Blind and their peers from the Heritage Montessori School participate in a social skills group. The group focuses on learning teamwork, communication, and leadership skills to be used throughout their lifetime. The skills are learned through hands-on experiences and group challenges. The challenge you're about to see is called the Great Cup Stack Challenge.
A teacher hands out two stacks of upside-down cups.
Now we've got two teams, a red team and a blue team. The challenge is to take a rubber band and put it over top of a cup.
Eight preteens sit around a table.
Using only the strings on the rubber band. So we're going to pass it around and you can check out the rubber band and the ribbons. Gracie, right in front of you, check out. You cannot use your hands at all.
Even if the cup falls, you put it in.
Even if the cup falls down to the ground, we're not going to use our hands.
Pull.
Later, three red team students hold a rubber band by the ribbons.
We're done. There we go.
They stretch the band over one cup and lift it off the stack.
All
right. Aside from learning important life skills, the students have learned how to develop true friendships despite their differences.
Walking as a group, the red team carries their cup to another table. Meanwhile, the blue team's stack of cups has fallen to the floor.
What happened, guys?
It fell over.
Oh, no.
The blue team tries to snag one end of the stack with their rubber band.
They fell off the table. Now, you guys, what do you have to do?
Pick them up.
Where, you have to pick up the whole stack?
Wait, no, where was Eddie?
Wait,
try
to pull it away.
Yeah. Or just one cup.
A blue team kid rights the stack with his foot.
Very clever. You're not allowed to use it. Uh-oh, I'm going to have to consult with Miss Kelly. On that one.
Okay, as long as no hands.
They get their band around the top of the cup and lift it.
You didn't say anything about feet, so.
I did not say anything about feet. That is problem.
Oh, dear. This is fantastic, blue team.
Later, the blue team works at placing the seventh cup on a cup pyramid. The four students holding four ribbons try to place the cup astride the two below it. It falls out of the rubber band and topples off the pyramid.
Ooh.
Later.
We had to try to get the cup around it, but it was difficult because one cup fell on the floor. So we had to pick it up at the string. We couldn't do it with our hands. So it was really difficult.
So it was difficult to figure it out.
When we got it up real high and we had to keep stacking it on just right so it wouldn't fall.
Okay, so working together to keep it from falling down. Was it hard for everybody to do the same thing at one time?
Yes.
Yeah.
What about teamwork? What teamwork skills did you use today?
Not to pull too hard or to move it forward.
Okay, so listening to each other?
Yeah.
So you used listening skills. What else? Mm-hmm. What other skills did we use today?
Explaining skills.
So giving directions and details. Could you have done that challenge alone?
No.
So you needed each other. When else in life do we need each other?
If they're having a problem.
If someone's having a problem, you use teamwork skills. Excellent. Laurel.
Use teamwork in families a lot too.
Yes, in families, making decisions in families. Yeah. What about jobs? What jobs require teamwork? Exactly. Firefighters need teamwork. Could they put out a fire all by themselves?
No.
It could be pretty dangerous to do something like that all by yourself. So you have to use communication and teamwork. What else? What other kind of a job? Terrell.
Like when you play football, you need the receivers and quarterbacks.
In sports, they really need a lot of teamwork, don't they? Do they use communication skills on sports teams?
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
How? Terrell.
Like when they say red, blue,
white. So people have to understand the different codes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So that's communication.
Mm-hmm. The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loaned described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved list of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.